Engines on. Five.
Apollo 15 paves the way for the most advanced lunar studies yet.
Launch commit. Liftoff. We have liftoff at 9:34 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time.
Endeavor Houston, we're ready for auto on the high gain, please.
After 5 days, they steer their ship, Falcon, to the surface.
Hello, Houston. Apollo 15. The Falcon is on its perch.
After surveying the geology, Scott makes the call. The rover is a go.
Okay.
They unfold it and head out. Geologists believe this particular region contains some of the moon's oldest rocks, which could help determine its age and origins.
We want to go back to the birth moments. We want baby pictures of the moon. And in the case of the moon, you get baby pictures through very old rocks.
We've stopped, and let's take a gander around.
One of their science stops is Spur Crater, the size of a football field.
Oh boy, it's a nice crater, isn't it? It sure is.
Here, geologists believe ancient rocks litter the ground.
What a beautiful sight.
If they're right, the samples would shed light on how the moon formed.
Okay, Jimmy, let's go to work. Oh, man, look at that.
Within minutes, something catches Scott's eye.
Look at the glimpse. Oh, I see twinning in there. Guess what we just found?
And Dave Scott suddenly turned and saw what looked like a glinting white rock.
Think we found what we came for. Crystal rock, huh? Yes, sir. You better believe it.
Scott and Irwin find something no other astronauts have seen. A white rock that could be from the moon's formation.
This is what they came for. They came for a kind of white rock that was thought to have been absolute earliest crust of the moon.
Dubbed the Genesis Rock, it helps geologists determine the moon is around the same age as Earth, 4.5 billion years old. The solar system itself is only slightly older.
They had actually found a piece of the moon's primordial crust and a chance to look back almost to the formation of the moon itself.
Bag number 196, a special bag.
Yes, sir.
Okay, Jim, let's get on a rover and get back. Oh, look at the mountains today, Jim, when they're all sunlit. Isn't that beautiful?
Apollo 15 samples will be studied for decades to come.
We went to the moon as trained observers in order to gather data, not only with our instruments on board, but with our minds.
Falcon, how do you read on box?
The astronauts have to leave the rover behind. But its camera provides one more thing. The first look at a lunar blast-off.
Ready to do some flying. Give them your go for liftoff.